Welcome to the Ragnar Oktoberfest 2019 Tournament Finals. That's been a full day of fantastic matches, culminating in this match we're about to watch right now. I'm Jangular, and I'll be with you through this match. This tournament is being run using the King of the Hill rules from the Blaster Tag Association. Let's give a quick rundown of the basics of those before this match starts. This is a 5v5 format played on a 125-foot by 125-foot field with a 6-minute time limit. There are 3 timers on the field that teams need to control by pushing the button for their side on each timer. When a team controls a timer, the display on the top left of your screen will show the time ticking up for each individual timer they control and their total score underneath that. The team with the most total time at the end of the match will be the winner. There are infinite respawns with a 15-second respawn timer in this game mode, which can be increased by penalties when those penalties are incurred, and that respawn timer starts when a player reaches their spawn. They may also sub out with another player on their team when they are not currently active on the field. Each team has a total of 300 darts per match that they may distribute among their players however they see fit. They may also scavenge from the field when those players are active. Now let's take a look at our 2 teams for this match today. First up, we have Null playing from the red side of the field, which will be on your right side of the screen. Their roster includes Dan running a Springer, Manateeks running Flywheels, Kelly running a Springer, Kuriaka running Springer, Colin running Flywheels, Squiggles running a Springer, and Random running a Springer as well. On the other side of the field, which is the blue side of the field, which will be on the left side of your screen, is Dauntless. Running for them today is Luke on Flywheels, Jangular on Flywheels. Just for clarification, yes, that is me. I don't have anyone else to commentate currently, unfortunately. But moving on, is Kyle on Flywheels, Drac on Springer, Callie on Springer, Addy on Springer, and Randall on both Flywheels and Springer. And as the teams line up, you can see the scoreboard now appearing on your screen. Those 3 circles represent the 3 hill timers from the left to the right as you see them on the field. The color of the inner dot of each circle represents the team that currently has control of that timer. Blue for Dauntless on the left and red for Null on the right. And the outer circle of each reflects how much time each team has held that timer comparatively. With that said, we're about to get underway with the finals for Ragnar Oktoberfest 2019. Both teams are lined up, ready to go, waiting for the signal. There it is, off the break. Both teams spreading out, trying to gain field position, taking their home side timers, left for Dauntless, right for Null. Time going up, you see Drac at the top of your screen, taking out one on the far side of the field, but Squiggles pushes mid, takes the timer for Null. They are now accruing points from the middle timer, 2 timers to 1. Null is in the lead. We see Drac in that back corner again, taking out another player, opening up the field for Dauntless. They are going to push forward and take not only middle, but the Null side right timer, accruing points on all 3 timers. Now this is a 3 cap. Null is going to have to respawn with all of their players while Dauntless is flooding the field, trying to lock them in spawn, accruing as many points as they can without having to expend any darts, which are the supreme currency in this format, as the more you spend early on, the more it hurts you later on. Squiggles does try to run in there along with, I believe that's Random, attempting to take back that home timer while Colin locks Jangular into place in that corner cover, moving back now, maybe going in for Randall, but deciding against it. Dauntless is still holding strong with all 5 up on Null's half of the field. This is something that Null is going to have to figure out. Colin rushes in, does take out Jangular while he is in the middle of a reload, a great time to come in. He is traded out, but that does open up possibilities for Null. However, Kuriaka is tagged out before he can take their respawn timer back again. The advantage for Dauntless is raising higher and higher and higher as this is going on. We now see Drac in that upper corner again, and he steps out of bounds, eliminating himself essentially, and he has to come back, and this allows Squiggles to run in, unbeknownst to the rest of their team, start causing havoc, and Null takes advantage of that havoc, that chaos, and just capitalizes, taking not only middle point, but eliminating everybody on Dauntless, pushing forward and reversing that 3 cap, now controlling the entire field from what was a complete lack of control not 15 to 20 seconds ago. This is going to gain them a lot of points while Dauntless is gaining 0. They can now spread out, establish a sense of dominance and good footing to hold Dauntless in their spawn, forcing them to make potentially bad trades or find a good shot. They have to be the playmakers now. This is a good time for Null to pick up extra darts as well, anything to give them a little bit of an advantage in this situation. Jangler's trying to draw the attention of one, but ends up moving further out with Randall to try and do a one-for-one trade with Kriok in that corner, which does work, but Randall is traded out by Colin, still netting a bonus for Null. This leaves Addy in that back left bunker. Drac again is in that corner trying to keep Manateek's attention. Here we see Kyle running in with him. They're going to try a one-for-one trade here, leaving them with an advantage. Kyle does in fact dodge a dart there. He is safe, and they're discussing it to make sure the clarification is there. But as it's happening, Kyle steps out of bounds and is eliminated again. That boundary line has been a boss monster for Dauntless in this match so far. We're a little bit over halfway, and Null is just chipping away at that Dauntless lead. They are now just 40 seconds away, and they are ever slowly creeping up on it. Now, Dauntless has taken back their home side timer, and Randall is able to spawn in this corner, take out Colin. Kriaka's pinned there. You see Squiggles running in. He's gonna be taking shots at Addy on that left piece of cover. She is taken out. Randall is also taking out from that corner piece of cover. In the bottom of your screen, we see Drac running back to spawn in the back of the field along with Kyle. Squiggles is now eliminated. It is still a Null advantage here on the field with only Jangler left in that far left piece of cover on your left of the screen. Now look at the timer. That lead that Dauntless had is gone. It is now a Null lead as Null continues to push forward on the field, controlling the flow of this game. Null has also, I believe, been switching players out and keeping legs fresh in the field while Dauntless has stuck with their starting five. Colin does make the error of running out of bounds, allowing Randall to come in, trade with one player. We see Kyle here on the backside of the field making a run, taking out one and two players, taking their home side right timer for Dauntless. Addy comes in, takes out Kuriaka, and Jangler will come in and take the middle timer here, resulting in a three cap for Dauntless. Again, a complete flip of the field for a third time this match. We see Dauntless, we have Colin and Kelly running down the right side of the field. Jangler locking them in, trading out with Kelly here, but Randall's able to replace him in that piece of cover, holding Colin in. On this far side again, we see two players coming in. Kyle takes out one, and Random does not spawn in. This prevents that two-for-one trade, allowing them to control that corner of the field. Colin does, however, take out Randall and pushes mid, taking control of that mid-timer. Also, getting tagged out, Addy does stay alive. Drac comes back in, takes that middle timer, and re-establishes the three cap. Now we see Drac also taking shots from that corner, but Jangler comes in and tags out Random, clearing that side of the field again. We see Kelly in their spawn, trying to stay alive, trying to get something happening. We now see Squiggles coming in, trying to push as well to middle. He does almost get to cover, but is taken out. It is now just kind of a string of spawns for Null rather than spawning in all together. And here we are with 5 seconds left. A last ditch effort to come into the field. Players are tagged out, and that is the final with a score of Dauntless with 609 to Null's 456. That is a Dauntless victory. Dauntless will be your 2019 Ragnaroktoberfest champions. We see the teams coming together to shake hands and congratulate each other on a fantastic match. That was a really exciting match to watch with the constant flips back and forth. It was a high-paced game with a lot going on. And seeing the sportsmanship here at the end and the players huddling together and just having a good time and appreciating each other is absolutely a fantastic aspect of this sport. The teams and the sportsmanship and the camaraderie is all just a wonderful aspect and is something that I hope we get to see all of you participating in the future as this continues to expand. We want to see competitive everywhere that people want to have it. So we hope if you have any interest in this, you've enjoyed it all, feel free to head to the website, blastertagassociation.com. We're on Facebook, we're on Discord, any of those places, feel free to contact us. We would love to see you playing and having another way to nerf among the many fantastic ways already available. This is one more great addition to it. Now, I do want to take a moment here to thank our sponsors for the prizes of this tournament. They're going to go ahead and flash up on your screen. Thank you to all of these sponsors who provided some wonderful prizes, some amazing pieces. that you just couldn't believe. We are so thankful to have that for this tournament for the participants. It went all the way down to fourth place, I believe, got prizes in this event. So with that said, thank you so much to all the teams that participated and made this event what it was. And on that note, what it was could not have been possible without the many volunteers, the referees we got from a paintball field, the prize support, as we mentioned, the volunteers making this run, the people filming, everyone that doubled down to make this happen. You are invaluable, and you are the things that make these events possible. So thank you so much, and we hope to see you all on the field in the future.